Yo, what's good YouTube? It's your boy Mr. Ghost, and I'm back with another trading video. So we have been getting good responses, good feedback, like views and all that, getting a group of people to the channel. So yeah, we have been doing that and it has been going good. So I just quickly want to put that out there before I start the whole video or just explain what the video is about. So today's video is basically just gonna be about a few tips all beginner forex traders should know before jumping into the forex market. So these tips are basically just gonna help you minimize the rate at which you are losing money while trading forex. So it's basically just gonna give you a few tips on how to stay profitable, how to maximize your profits, and how to cut short your losses. Because remember, being a forex trader means that losses are part of the game. So don't be discouraged just because you lost a few trades and all that. And also remember, don't revenge trade, but we'll get into that in the middle of the video or as we go about the video. So yeah, it's Mr. Lacoste, and yeah, with all that said, let's get into the YouTube video. And yeah, so point number one is gonna be risk management. Okay, I personally believe that a trader who doesn't have risk management isn't a forex trader, basically. And also, being a forex trader doesn't mean I'm making profits. Making profits is something else, but being a profitable forex trader basically means you cutting your risk short, losing less and winning more. So it doesn't basically make sense, or it doesn't make sense you calling yourself a forex trader but yet you are still blowing accounts. So being a forex trader means minimizing your negative trades, not blowing your account. If you are still blowing accounts up until this stage, up until today, please don't call yourself a forex trader. And please stop, just put the trading account on the side, just put your phone down, and for 1 minute just think, how can I stop blowing accounts? Basically, what is it that I have to do, that I have to learn to minimize the risk of blowing accounts? Because I've been seeing a lot of forex traders out here in Namibia just trading, basically hustling a few cash, hiding cash and whatnot, hustling a few money, and then basically just coming to the forex market and just blowing it that same day. And it's really discouraging and all that, because I know I have gone through that. So I'm basically just here to give you a few pointers on how not to basically blow your account and be profitable forex trade. So point one was risk management. So you as a person watching this, the thought will come to your mind, like if it's your first time hearing the word risk management, the thought to your mind will come, what is risk management and how can I implement it into trading myself, you as a person? So risk management is basically just you managing your risk before entering a trade, just checking out your account balance and basically just figuring out how much you are willing to risk on that specific trade you're about to place. So just calculating, say, no, my trading account is, for example, maybe on $400 now. So you as a person, your risk management skill, or yeah, just your risk management, what you draw up, is basically just gonna tell you that no, in this one trade I placed, maybe on NASDAQ for example, I placed one trade with a lot size of 0.01, as you as an example. So yeah, I placed a trade of 0.01, so my stop loss is engineered or placed in a way that says that no, if this trade goes against me, I'm only gonna be losing, say, 1% of that trade basically, or 1% of your account, meaning that you will be meaning that you'll be losing around about, say, $100 from that $400 trade. So this is basically just risk management, risk, or calculating your risk to the lowest, minimum amount you can possibly lose, and putting your reward as the highest possible amount you can earn. So that's risk management. So point two is basically finding a trading strategy that works for you. So I've been seeing, or there are a lot of forex trading strategies out there, free ones, paid ones, and all that. So for you as a person, if you want to buy a forex strategy, or you want to learn a forex strategy that's paid, that's okay, it's whatnot, you can go get it. If you are a person that's not well off, that doesn't actually have money to pay for mentorship, forex classes, and all that, we do that for free, but that's not the point. So the point is just basically getting out there, going on YouTube, even as on this channel or another channel you might have, and basically just finding a strategy or finding a mentor first that explains a forex strategy, and you as a person also just finding out, doing a bit of research on this person and seeing, oh, does this strategy actually work, and also hitting up or basically just communicating with other people who actually pay for that person's courses and strategies and all that, and just basically talking to those people and finding out whether those strategies actually work. Yeah, and just basically sticking to one strategy. Don't just go out there and take all these trading strategies and try to implement four trading strategies on one trade. No, it's gonna go bad, that's a guarantee. So basically just get that one trading strategy, work on it, put in the effort, and basically just put in this small point on how you can perfect that one trading strategy, because trust me, just sticking to one trading strategy can make you a very profitable forex trader. So yeah, that was point two. So point three is basically just gonna be being patient. Patience is the word. Patience. Say it with me. Don't be shy. Just say it with me. Patience is the key to success. Okay? One more time. Patience is the key to success. So patience is your number one friend when it comes to trading forex. So patience basically means that once you set a trade or once you place a trade, you have to be patient and not go to the trade trying to close it once you see a bit of profit, or try closing it once you see a bit of losses. No, once you place a trade, it's very important that you put your phone aside and just go about your normal day routine. Stop stressing about the trade. If you have faith in the trading strategy I talked about, if you have faith in the trading strategy you have, then yeah, just let the trade run. Basically, and if you don't have faith in these mentors that send you signals and all that whatnot, don't take the trade. Don't take something that you are not confident with or confident in. So yeah, basically, if you place a trade, be patient. Let the trade run. Stop going to the trade trying to adjust whatnot. Maybe if you adjust your stop loss and take profit, that's all. But don't go to the trade and just monitor, just on your phone. The trade is hard. No, leave. Don't do that. Being a forex trader is you mastering the art of being patient, basically. Because guys, patience is the key to success. I won't lie to you. Because now imagine you place the trade. The trade is in $400 in profit. Now you are just there like, no. It might go down, whatnot. Let me close. You close it. Okay, you will go home with a bit of profits and whatnot. Yeah, you will be happy. But just imagine the feeling of regret after you see, oh, maybe you're in a buy and you closed it at the, yeah, you closed the buy. Then as soon as you close the buy, it shoots up. Then from 400, it goes to you possibly could have making, let's say, 10,000 even US dollars. You just imagine the regret you will feel. You'll just be there, what if I was in the trade long enough? What if this? It's you yourself. So you will feel bad about it. The regret will be eating you inside. So yeah, that's basically point number three, if I'm right. So yeah, just be patient, let your trades run. Don't be trying to adjust whatnot, trying to be using bolt. You know, leave the trade, let it run. So point number four, this is a personal point I think every forex trader or beginner forex trader should know by now, is basically being humble. I'm just gonna give you guys time just so that can marinate and set in. Being humble. Humble. That's a very strong point. Which, yeah, it's a very strong point. Because being humble, you as a beginner forex trader, means that you are gonna be saving money. Because let's just be honest. Forex traders these days, okay, if you're a forex trader and you're busy watching this, just back this point up with me in the comment section below and just comment whether I'm right or whether I'm wrong. But forex trader these days, in our world of today, they are basically, people require more from us. It's like if you pull up somewhere, maybe to a club, the catch, jokers, anyway, popping, you basically just pull up there, okay? You're dressed official and whatnot, not even official, okay? You're dripping and all that. Nah. You pull up and people notice that you're a forex trader. Maybe you have your company logo on your shirt and whatnot, as the forex trader guys are doing these days. So yeah, let me make an example of Amushe. Okay, so say Amushe pulls up to the catch. Okay, he's at the catch, he's vibing and whatnot. He orders a few drinks, whatnot. So immediately when people realize that you're a forex trader, they're gonna be like, ah, why is this guy just buying this and not buying that? Why is this guy driving Ranex or BMW? Why is he not driving a G-Wagon? You see? Why is this guy having this and not having that? So people like putting forex trader on or being a forex trader on they always expect a lot from us. It's like, why don't you do it? Why don't you buy the G-Wagon? Why should I have to buy that? It's just be humble, basically. Just be humble. Just be humble. The following point is not revenge trading. So I'm just gonna go through this a bit quicker because I'm checking the minutes are going up. So yeah, not revenge trading. By that I mean, revenge trading is, say, you open a trade on NAS 100, as I have the charts behind me. So say you open a trade on NAS 100 and you lose half of your account. Revenge trading comes in when you say, no, I lost half of my account, let me try making it back. So then you jump into the forex market just even by a simple strategy or simple thing. Yeah, so you know it will go down now, let me sell it, whatnot. You open the trade, it goes bad again, you lose the whole account. So revenge trading is, it's a bad thing. It's really a bad thing because now you're trying to make up for the losses you had. Going back to the first few things I said during the video, making losses is part of the game. Being a forex trader means that you will at some point of your trading career make losses. If you are not currently making losses, oh, that's good. Share the trading also share the trading strategy and whatnot you use in the comment section below for other people to learn. And because yeah, me myself, yeah, I would also want to learn a trading strategy that means I'm not losing any money. Your profit should be more than your losses, guys. Please, the aim is to be profitable, not just donating your whole money to forex market. So yeah, keep that in mind. So yeah, the following point is gonna be drawing up a trading plan, basically. So the trading plan, I'm just gonna go through this quick. If you guys maybe want me to explain more on a certain point I said, just comment down below, because I'm just gonna be going through the points a bit quicker because the minutes are stacking up and most people don't want to spend 20 minutes and whatnot minutes on one video. So yeah, the next point is gonna be drawing up a trading plan. So a trading plan is basically just a written, just basically you writing down your goals and aims for the week, for the day, for the month trading. So you're basically just gonna, before the start of the week, I mostly like doing this on a Sunday. So on the Sunday, I'll basically just come down, sit down at my table, maybe just play a relaxing song, just get into the relaxing vibe, and basically just draw down on how much it is I want to be making that specific day or that specific week or month. So Say I was to draw, okay, my trading plan for this week was maybe make around about $100 a day. It's a small goal, but whatnot. It keeps me in the game and it keeps me focused. So what this does is, once my trade is on $100 in profits, I would immediately close it because I have reached the daily target I set for myself. Yeah, the following point is startup capital. I see a lot of guys asking me whether they can start trading Forex with 150 or 200 Namibian dollars. Ish. Okay, it is possible, but I wouldn't recommend that, because let's be honest, starting or depositing a 150 or 200 Namibian dollars, it won't really give you equity to as to holding the trade, because as soon as you try holding a trade and you open the big lot size, even a small lot size, it's like trades normally run in negatives for a bit or for a while before going into profits. So at the end, I'm just wondering whether your account will survive just that movement of the market before it potentially goes into profit. So a 200 and 150 account, I'm not that sure. But yeah, if you can try it, if it works for you, share it with us, like I said. So yeah, capital. The amount I would strongly advise is, say, from 1,000 or 1.5 upwards, yeah, then you can start trading. Yeah, that's a stable amount, or that's the amount I mostly suggest to people that start trading or to beginner forex traders. Because okay, 1k you can carry, but it's gonna be a little hassle. But yeah, it will also just give you a bit of leverage and equity on holding trades. So yeah, startup capital. Then also lot sizes, finding the appropriate lot size for your account. So lot size is basically just how much money you want to enter a trade. I would strongly advise, since this video is solely meant for beginner forex traders, I would solely advise you trading with smaller lot sizes. Don't increase your lot size just because the guy you saw on Instagram is making this much from a lot size of $1. Don't do that. You will blow your account, and that's a guarantee. I can bet on that with you. So don't try doing things other people are doing on social media. No. Stick to your lot size. If your account is small, stick to a small lot size. If your account is big, still stick to a smaller lot size, but gradually increase it as you start getting the hang of trading. So yeah, the next point is gonna be using stop loss and take profit in your advantage. So what I mean by this is basically just locking in or clocking profits. So as you are trading, say you have three trades open, maybe you close one and let the other two run. As it's in profit, you close this one, you let the other one run, just like that. The aim is to close profits and not just to hold profits or hold trades, just taking screenshots, showing your people, no, I'm making this much, but in reality you haven't actually closed that trades, or the trade or the money didn't actually show up to your dashboard. So it's very important to log profits, close profits, take profits and all that. So using your stop loss to your advantage is basically, you say you open a trade on Nasdaq again. Okay? I love it. So yeah, say you open a trade on Nasdaq, it's in profit, it's running deep in profit. So now you want to make sure, in case the market comes crashing down and takes you out in negatives, so you want to learn, or you basically just want to protect your profits. So what you would normally do is move your stop loss to break even. So what this does is, in case the market comes back down again, you're in a buy. In case the market comes crashing down again, your stop loss is basically just gonna take you out of the trade before you even lose any money. So yeah, it's a win-win. So learn to use your stop loss or learn to move your stop loss to break even. Okay, and then the last but final point, this one is very important, guys. Stop doing this. I myself used to do this, but now it's better. Not better, there are a few times where I catch myself slacking, but yeah, don't revenge trade. Oh, not revenge trade, we already talked about that. But don't social trade. Social trading basically means that you place a trade just because someone on social media, whether it's on Instagram, on TikTok, or whatever you use, just because that person placed a trade, you're also placing a trade. Without doing any analysis, the person just opens a buy, you're also opening a buy. Person sells, you're also selling. As a person or as a forex trader, that's bad. It just even shows that you don't have confidence in your own trading strategy or your trading plan. And this can also be bad, because what if that person is busy trading a demo account? He's not losing money. You are losing money when you place those trades on your real account. So don't take funny signals on social media unless you know this person's strategy actually makes money, guys. These are just a few tips to avoid you from blowing your account. So yeah, that was all for the video of today. So guys, please, if you are not subscribed, please subscribe. Just hit that red subscribe button, which is just click it for me. Okay, yes, thank you. I'm even gonna give you a bit of time. If you didn't, just click on that subscribe button, just hit the like button, and just comment down below what you don't understand in the forex, which I should explain on the next video. So yeah guys, that's basically it.